In last class, we have seen how to separate the impedances, series impedances of transformer equivalent circuit, that is primary resistance and leakage reactance, and secondary resistance, winding resistance and leakage reactance. How to separate these two quantities based on the data we will get from short circuit test has been discussed in one method, has been discussed in our last class. Series opposition test is another method actually. So let me draw the transformer equivalent circuit once again. So this is series resistance, inductance, leakage inductance, and then leakage inductance, and then resistance of primary and secondary respectively. So then there is a shunt branch which represents core loss resistance, and then magnetization inductance, right? Now this is the equivalent circuit that we discussed the other day. Now the objective is to separate this R1JX1 and R2JX2, of course. So R1JX1 or RPJXP, let us label RPJXP, XS, RS, right? Now how to separate these two by making some tests, external tests. The accessible terminals are these two, 1-1 dash, say 2-2 dash. Now these 2-2 dash is also not directly accessible, so there will be a transformer, ideal transformer here. So this is secondary of this ideal transformer. In fact, these two terminals, so say, let us say 3-3 dash, these two terminals are accessible to us, but indirectly we can assume that these terminals are 2-2 dash are accessible. Of course, we have to use appropriate transformer to make the potential connect at 3-3 dash, so that the outside potentials are equal to 2-2 dash, then we can have that access to them. Now so what is the way? Now we have access of 1 and say terminal 2, then if we connect, if we could connect a source like this, say a source like this, and measure voltage here also by connecting voltmeters, one say V1 and another voltmeter V2. So then directly we can get V2, and then the current also, we can measure the current using some ammeter here. So if we can measure like this, it would be beautiful. But this terminal, whether this terminal is accessible or not, yes, if we keep everything open means this 1-1 dash, 1 dash and 2 dash open, then there will be no current in this branch, I0 equals to 0, right? How to achieve this, how to achieve 1 dash and 2 dash open, that we will see later. But if we can achieve that, so then this node, I0 is 0, and this node is the same as this node. So let me label this 4 and 4 dash are same, right? So this can be used as a 4 dash means, again, it is 1 dash and 2 dash only. So since it is accessible, then we can get the voltage across the primary winding. Winding means primary impedance. So then primary, this voltage divided by current will give us primary impedance separately. So this is how we can do. But connecting at 4 dash, So it is same as connecting it one dash. So indirectly we are measuring the voltage across the input of the transformer. But what about V2? V2 also we have to connect between 2 and 2 dash terminals, of course. So what are these actually, 2 and 2 dash? Either if this transformer is there, ideal transformer is there, how to access that, and I'll just think about it. So if it is say 1:1 transformer, just consider 1:1 transformer, though, so that there is no problem of turns ratio and all. So in that case, simply the transformer connections, so like this. Now this is primary, this is secondary. Now the as per the above diagram, the connection is, you know, the source is connected between this winding and then this winding. This is secondary winding actually. So we have to connect a source like this. If we connect a source like this, then as long as these two windings are open, we cannot have any current going through the windings at all. So this third point where there is a connection between this this can be realized that by connecting like this actually. So then an ammeter can also be connected like this. So this is the equivalent circuit of this connection actually. This connection where the current flows through the secondary winding impedance also, including leakage impedance, leakage reactance. So this is how the connection will be. Since the turns ratio is equal in this case, whatever current goes here I, the same current will come out like this I. Therefore the flux, the net flux is zero, phi is zero. Please remember, this is not the same case as we connect the transformer, then when the load current flows, which counters the input primary and all. We are not at all giving any input voltage to this winding, please remember. We are only allowing the currents to flow. And since currents are equal and opposite, the flux is also equal and opposite, cancels out each other. There will be no magnetization flux because there is no input voltage here. Of course, negligible voltage drop will be there, but that is neglected completely. So effectively there is no input voltage here, so there is no magnetization branch current here. Only this whatever primary current is there, it will flow through the secondary, which will counter that. So effectively there is no magnetization flux, therefore the induced voltage across this core loss branch or core component, core loss inductance and then magnetization in core loss resistance and magnetization in inductance, across this the voltage is zero. That is what is needed for us. If there is a drop here, then the measurement of V1 across the winding will not give us the voltage across this impedance RP plus JXP. Now how to measure the voltage? For measuring the voltage across the primary winding impedance, we have to connect a voltmeter V1 here and another voltmeter V2 here, like this. So this is the arrangement. This is for 1:1 transformer. This is actually equivalent to this. Same. Now V1 will give you voltage across RP plus JXP. V2 will give us the voltage across RS plus JXS, and ammeter reading is already there, which will give us the current here. So this voltage divided by current, V1 by I, will give us the impedance, primary impedance, and then V2 by I will give us the secondary impedance, and then it can be easily estimated. But here one problem is there. See, if what is the problem if induced EMF is there? Induced EMF will actually reflect here in this shunt branch. Then the primary voltage, we have to write the equation V1 is equal to RP plus JXP into I1 plus E1, that induced EMF. And then secondary winding voltage V2 is equal to E2 minus RP plus JX, RS plus JXS into I again. So this problem will come, E will be there, induced EMF E will be there. If phi is equal to 0, there will be no induced EMF voltage drop here. The drop complete, the voltage measured V1 is the voltage across the winding impedance. It is not the not having any induced EMF component. So that is what is needed. But if it is not 1:1 transformer, suppose we have N1:N2, or for simple reason you can assume that 1:N transformer or N:1 transformer. If you have N1:N2 transformer, how to make the connections? So that is very important here. So this is how to realize that one. This is say primary of, this is main transformer which you are subjecting it for series opposition test. This is the primary, this is the primary, this is the secondary winding. Now the connection has to be done, because see the current should be same now. So here we connect another transformer of, you know, similar turn ratio, opposite turn ratio, means inverted turn ratio. So here again that transformer will connect. Now actually we have to connect to this terminal, but the current is not same, right? If the voltage, if the turns ratio is not same, current is not same. This is N1:N2, and here again N2:N1 transformer has to be used. Now this is how we will connect. This is the voltage source. It is connected like this, and this is the current source, ammeter, like this. Now will it happen the same way as the previous case? Yes, see, you can see this is current I. Again due to turns ratio and all, I2 current will go through this one in opposite direction. And then the same amount of the current will go through this winding also. And then in the outside winding, you will get exactly same current in this direction. So that's how the current is actually transformed here. The objective is to have a matching current in the secondary winding. So that is achieved by connecting a transformer. Since this is mainly the purpose is to transform the current, this is a current transformer, not a potential transformer. Now the voltmeters, where we have to connect, the voltmeter one here V1 and the other here V2. So this is how series opposition test is to be conducted. Then once we get values of V1 and I, then primary leakage reactance and resistance RP plus JXP is given by V1 divided by I, and then RS plus JXS is given by V2 divided by I. So this is how it is achieved. So one thing that has to be remembered here is there is no magnetization component here, therefore there is no induced EMF in the winding V1 or in the winding of transformer city also here. So that is how elimination of induced EMF is important for this series winding, series opposition test. So the series opposition test is used for separating the impedances. Actually, in open circuit or short circuit test especially, we will get a complete series branch impedance, that is R plus JX, which is equal to RP plus RS plus J into XP plus XS. This is what we will get in short circuit test. So after the AC test, we can use this. Even we can directly use this because we will get separate impedances directly. So this is how we can do. But together with this series short circuit test also, we can do this. In that case, using short circuit test, we will obtain this complex impedance R plus JX. Now the ratio of impedances can be obtained using series opposition test instead of just magnitudes. See, V1 by I magnitude I know, and then V2 by I magnitude I know. Using these magnitudes, again assuming the phase as same, we can divide this R plus JX into two components, that is primary and secondary components. Of course, in that case, we have to assume that the phase angle of this impedance is same for both primary and secondary. So this is how the separation of impedances can be done for a transformer equivalent circuit. So next we will see the exciting current, etc., in our next class. Thank you.